and good morning to all of you. Am I audible? I have a bad throat, so. I bring greetings to you from India. I head the Center for Sports Medicine, and this is a BWF-funded project to develop a badminton-specific injury prevention program. You know, the popularity of the sport has increased tremendously. There are over 250 million people who play badminton, making it arguably the best or the most sought after racket sport, if not the best. On the other side, if you look at the number of injuries has increased because the game has become fast-paced now. The athletes are probably more fitter now, but the amount of games they play, the amount of training that they undergo, it makes them at risk of developing injuries. But till now, we don't have a specific badminton injury prevention program. So this is just a modest attempt to come up with a badminton specific injury prevention program. Okay, so that's the background. And the objective is this. You might have heard about FIFA 11 Plus, the injury prevention program for soccer. That has been there for the last maybe about 7 or 8 years. But even that wasn't scientifically designed. So that means the sport was not analyzed properly, but then they have come up with a program. So this is to analyze the biomechanical demands of the sport and then come up with an injury prevention program. And the second part is to test how effective this program is to reduce injuries. In phase one, what we did was we developed the badminton specific injury prevention program. How we did that is we analyzed 11 university players. We did both biomechanical analysis of their movement, and also we used a plantar pressure inside their footwear to analyze how much pressures they underwent. And we looked at four strokes. We looked at reaching for the drop on the forehand side, backhand, smash, and an overhead clear.
Can you see the positions while
So after analyzing this, we got inputs from the strength and conditioning coaches, physios, and then we came up with the injury prevention program. And this is the So largely, this is a set of 21 exercises. You can categorize them into stability exercises, which will improve the stability around the hip. Because we personally believe, if you have a good pelvic control, most of the injuries can be prevented. Okay, so exercises to improve stability, exercises to improve the neuromuscular control and flexibility. The first two is done along with their training, and flexibility exercises towards the end of the training session. This is a short 1 minute, 50 second video. So this is to improve the scapular stability. So you can look at that, we progress to a shorter race, to a very short race. And this is to recruit the amount of rhomboids and the middle traps. This is for the pelvic stability exercises. And this is for the gluteus medius activation, external rotators. And this is one exercise that we think has really helped in improving the injury. These are simple exercises. With very little equipment, this can be done. And these are the neuromuscular control exercises. And this is one stroke in which most of the athletes are at injury risk for ACL. And also, yeah, these are the stretching exercises. This is for the full posterior chain. The capsular stretch. And this is for the lats. Most of the badminton players have a very tight lats. This is the myofascial release.
I hear a lot about the ball exercises.
Yeah. And this is for the posterior capsule again.
I want to try it.
We don't have the ball, but I wish you can. And this is for the pectoralis minor. There is a small muscle here. And this is for the piriformis, because every now and then when they reach, it becomes tight. It takes about 15 to 20 minutes to do this exercise. If they can do it 5 days a week, we have found significant improvement in the injury risk.
And this is
the last one.
It's like a
So what, in the second phase, what we did was we made them do this exercise 5 days a week for 8 to 10 weeks. Initially, we wanted to do it for 12 weeks, but then we did for 8 to 10 weeks because by 8 weeks, we already started seeing improvement. So then we wanted to stop the study early. So some of them did for about 10 weeks, some of them did for about 8 weeks. But these are the ones that we looked at. And we wanted to see if this has any effect on flexibility, stability. Proprioception is the ability to memorize the position of the joint. And balance, and then movement to come and kind of be substroke. These are the things that we wanted to know if this improves. See what we have found. We didn't find much improvement in flexibility. It was quite surprising for us. But what we found was there was a huge improvement in balance and movement impairment. And proprioception and stability, we found improvement, but it is not large improvement. The reason is probably we chose only 11 subjects in each group. When we do it on more number of people, probably the magnitude of the improvement will be high. But these are the key. So the blue line represents the badminton specific injury prevention program. You can see that it has increased. That means this is a posterior medial direction in which they do reach like this. Okay. We found an improvement of close to 13 centimeters. Okay, that's a significant improvement. And this improvement goes a long way in preventing injuries, especially injuries of the knee and the ankle. Okay, and the same holds good for the posterior lateral direction. Posterior lateral direction is standing here and then trying to reach as much as possible. We found improvement there too. And anterior direction is this. We didn't find much of a difference in both groups. This is probably because badminton is a sport where it is predominantly they move faster in the front. So, but this is a crucial finding that we have come up with. And this is in landing. You would have seen Carolina Marin's injury of her ACL. Okay, most of these is because they don't have good landing strategy as they convert the forehand to a backhand. Okay. So what this has done is, this is the basic group. You can see that a higher score means higher injury risk. So in the backhand specific injury prevention group, there was a big drop. And anything less than 5 is fantastic to prevent injuries. And that is what we have found. Okay, so the landing mechanics have improved. So the way how they land, especially with the exercises that we did with the balance pad, that has gone a long way in preventing injuries. So this is the impression. This is the impression. So we have found significant improvement in balance and proprioception. Okay. Even if it doesn't prevent the number of injuries, but at least it will prevent the severity of injuries. If we do these exercises every day and they train, and it takes only about 15 to 20 minutes. But practically speaking, we found it hard to convince the coaches to make them do this for 15-20 minutes. Okay? So maybe with your awards, you can try and implement this for about 5 days a week. Okay, that would be fantastic. And also we found marginal improvement in stability. How we did stability was we made them do a close kinetic chain test where they keep it at 30 centimeters and then they do this. In that also we found improvement, but it is very small. But we did not find any improvement in flexibility. This is probably because the previous day they would have strained themselves more, which could have prevented them from being from showing the injury. I take this opportunity to thank BWF because this is a funded project and this is the team. In fact, that is only a 1-minute, 50-second video. In probably a month's time, this video will be uploaded at the BWF site. And that will have auditory cues, it will have visual cues, it will have lines running. So you will be able to see that.
Thank you.
Have a good day.
Thank you.